I know. So just to recap, guys, we got sell side liquidity. Ignore this. We got sell side liquidity below these lows. We got a bullish bias. We got bullish news release. Here we were right before news, right here. So price pushed up, waiting for price to either swipe this sell side or this buy side liquidity, and then give us an entry point. I'm game to play the market either way today. We're pushing on the dollar. It's a 4 hour. But we are inside this order block on the 4 hour as well. On the DXY. So we'll see. All right. I am going to track this high as well, guys. This is the high that was put in from news. But definitely would not be mad at all to see price just run through here and grab some of these highs. But we'll play whatever the market's willing to give us. But just for shits and giggles, let's see where we're at. This was 8:30. Yeah, I mean, the only trade that you could have really gotten, like if you were trading at opening bell, I mean, you could have done this, right? Like, obviously hindsight's 20/20. But like this order block would have been the trade, right? Click down, order block, sell off. But based on the strategy that we've been trading SP 500, right? We want to see a liquidity sweep first to kind of feel that next move, which we really weren't, really wasn't that. Lower it is if I notice the stop loss, like we're really volatile and the stop loss is like 10, 12 points. That's when I'll lower, like I'll cut it in half. She said she too young, don't want no man. So she gonna call. All right, there we go. We're getting some movement. It looks like we're going to draw this liquidity first. That's kind of the idea right now. So if we sweep this sell side, give us a 1 minute break of structure, that'll be our trade for a buy, which is in line with the 1 hour bias. It is in line with the news. The market's up as well. There we go. So we're tapping into this fair value gap now on the 15-minute. When I was pointing out these levels of sell-side liquidity that I felt like could be a huge magnet for price, like why not, you know, when this news spiked up, grabbed this high, why weren't we playing sells from that point? And I guess my answer to that is just, could you have done that in hindsight? Obviously, in hindsight, you could have, but you really feel like when price was picking up like this, knowing that the news was bullish for SP 500, you really would have wanted to sell at that point? We were targeting buy side up here at that point, right? The price pulled down, stopped around. No breakup structure until literally right here at the candle. So, I don't know, what was that risk reward, like a 1-to-1? You could put it above this high technically, but realistically you should put it above the liquidity sweep. But it looks like we're getting a low here. I'm sorry, a high. But this is why we want to wait for the breakup structure, because you guys see price comes down. Right now, we pulled right back to this low and we're rejecting. So now what we want to see is price to, I want this candle to close bearish, first of all. I want this to close bearish, and then this candle give us, you know, either this candle or any of the next few candles give us a breakout structure. But if we get a new high to form, we can change our entry. But I want to use this order block. All right, if we get a candle close above this red line, I'm going to enter. Candle has to close above this red line though, guys. Can't wick past it and come back, it has to close above it. So if we end up getting a little bit worse of an entry point, that's totally fine. You know, you can adjust your lot size if you need to in that case. Or if it pulls, if it really pushes, we'll wait for a pullback entry. But TP1 is going to be this order block, guys, for me. TP2 this high, TP3 this high, TP4 that high. I'll turn the music down a little bit more since we're getting close to actually getting in a trade. But let me know if it's still too loud. I don't want it to like annoy you guys. I can't really even hear it, to be honest. It's like super quiet because I'm sharing it on Zoom. But yeah, I'm just waiting. I got my finger over the buy button. I'm gonna set my stop, the low here. If this candle closes bearish, we'll move our low down to, or our high down to here. This candle wick right here. Another thing that you guys could do, let's say like this really pushed, right? Like let's say it pushed up to here and you didn't want to put your full lot size on because the break of structure was so big, but you're like, well, what if it doesn't come back? Because sometimes it doesn't come back and give you an entry. What you could do is you could take like half your lot size, enter, and then put your other half on if it does pull back. That's one thing that you could do to play. I'm just giving you guys options. But all right, I'm in. I took a buy right at the close of that candle. My fill was pretty decent as well, like right here. But there's no fair value gaps left in here, guys. So, I mean, any pullbacks would just be into like this order block, I guess. But we've got plenty of confirmations for this trade. We swept sell side liquidity. We're bullish with our news. We're bullish with 1 hour structure, pre-market and post-market. The 1 hour candle that came after market open never closed below the previous low. So yeah, we are sticking to our rules. This is our plan. We got our sweep of liquidity, break of structure, and we're in. So I'm gonna take half off at TP1, remove my risk. And then I'll just partial at these other TPs. I'll do half off here. I'll probably do like a third off. I'm just guesstimating here into the future, but I'd probably take like a third off here because it's not like, this is actually the high to me where liquidity would be sitting. Order block, liquidity. And then we'll see if it wants to give us anything from there. So we got a fair value gap left behind on this candle, guys, that we entered off of. So we could see a pullback into that. If you miss the entry, that could be your entry. See what US 30 is doing and Q is doing. US 30 pushed through the low. Notice how NQ didn't, but look where it came to. It's like one of those Instagram entries. So what we want to see, guys, I mean, I'm going to hold the trade either way. I'm just, you know, commentating on this, but we want to see these candles continue to just respect this fair value gap. It'd be not ideal for us to see a candle close below here. That kind of gives us a sign that the fair value gap isn't willing to hold. Uh-oh. There's red on the screen. What's up? I'm still in. That was close. All right, I'm out. That wig got me out. 9:40 though, 20 minutes till 10 Central. We gotta draw on this liquidity. Yeah. L for us today. But I'm gonna post this to YouTube as well, guys. Is there any questions on the setup? We followed all of our rules. Buy or sell side liquidity was taken, break a structure, entry point, a little bit of profit, well, 3.5 points of profit. No, four and a half points almost. And then stopped out. Justin said he's still in. Yeah, if you put your, I messed up with my stop loss. I don't know what I was thinking. 118, I just moved it. And then, yeah. But if you had your spread accounted, added to this low, you could definitely still be in the trade right now. But yeah, I got stopped out. Let's look here. So 15 minute, I'm going to monitor this during PM session, probably on like the 5 minute chart, 3 minute chart, and see if we get any sort of, you know, reaction out of this fair value gap. Once we either close it fully, maybe tap into this order block. There you go. Yeah. It's pushing now. Oh yeah. So we'll see though, if we get another bullish reaction with a break of structure with a fair value gap left behind, I'm willing to play buys again, you know, a little bit later today. So I'm just going to monitor this, guys. I'm going to keep you guys updated in the Discord. All good. Stop losses hit. This is part of trading. You know, hopefully you guys, you know, didn't get too spoiled from yesterday with all take profits being hit. And then, you know, then today we hit a stop loss and now you guys are down in the dumps. So still up on the week, but we manage our risk on Forex. Manage our risk on SPX today. And, you know, even if we were trading opening bell, it wouldn't have worked out either. So it's good that we waited for news. It just didn't give us the setup that we wanted yet. So but I'll keep you guys updated in the Discord, guys. And yeah, we'll end it there. Appreciate you guys. I'll talk to you guys in the Discord. Talk to you guys later today.